but it's, what is your fundamental philosophy of the business? Do you believe in Peter Drucker, who said the purpose of the business is to create, keep a customer? Or do you go down to Friedman's line? The only purpose of the business is to make a profit. If you believe that, and then you get into those dark times where you're faced with challenges and ethical issues, you're going to get to the wrong place. Your managers will be in the wrong place. So these things are very important. When you're hiring, are people believing that they can control the variables that will ultimately lead to success, or are they just going to be victims? You don't want those people. So you need to question these things. And finally, the principle of expectation. This old research was done by some professors in Europe, and they really thought this was wonderful. They taught the horse to add, subtract, and do multiplication. So other people came in to do the research, and they found the horse could only do math when the researcher was there. It was the principle of expectation. It turned up in My Fair Lady. George Pygmalion believed he could make the little flower girl into a lady. And that principle of expectation led to that success. And the other key thing is, I recall a story, 1970, the head of the Biomedical Computer Center at Tulane University, a medical professor and a doctor, wanted to promote the janitor into his data center. And everybody said, you can't do it. He said, I quit. You know, being a professor, he has several jobs. They said, no, we don't need to quit. We'll give him an IQ test. So this black guy fails the IQ test. This guy said, I know I can do it. Either let me do it or I quit. So they let him do it. And 3 years later, the guy ended up as supervisor of the data center, hiring, recruiting, training, and motivating staff. It had more to do with the expectations of the boss, of the guy.